When you consider Hashem as a father, as a mother, he will be next to you.
Rav Jaker, the Rav of the Kehila, Avi, the President of the Kehila, the Committee, Kal Kadosh. Be'ezat Hashem, we will try to explain exactly during this week what happened exactly between Yosef and his brothers. We know one thing. Shluchi mitzvah inam nizukin. When somebody does a mitzvah, you can be sure that nothing bad will happen to him. If somebody goes to Australia for a mitzvah, be'ezat Hashem, he can be sure that he will come back safe. Here we have a big problem with Yosef. According to Chachamim, Yosef a tzaddik, he was the best. He was a tzaddik. He was very, very much. Yaakov Abinu loved him so much. He teach him all the Torah that Yaakov Abinu learned from the yeshiva of Shem Be'ever. He teach it to Yosef. Yosef was very clever. He kept all what Yaakov Abinu learned on hundreds of years. And Yosef a tzaddik, he has a brain, phenomenal. He could catch everything. And at the age of 17 years old, he knew all what his father knew. He was Bar Hakim, was very intelligent. So of course, we cannot imagine one thing, that after all the problems that he had with his brothers, the dreams, I don't want to go into these details, because it's a lot of to talk about that. But now, I want just to know one thing. Yaakov Abinu, after a few days that he did not see his children, he said to Yosef, I want you to go to see how is your children, how is your brothers, how is the sheep. I want you to go. And he went with him. And he did the Levaya. I mean, he went with him maybe a few miles. And then they spoke Divrei Torah. Then I don't understand. What happened to Yosef at the end? He was sold, nearly was killed. What about the mitzvah? He went, Shluchi mitzvah inam nizukin. He went and the orders of his father. His father, he told him, go, he's a kibud av ha'em. And Yosef, he knows that his brothers, they hate him. He knows he's very dangerous. But there is kibud av ha'em. There is, you have to respect your father and mother. And Papa and my father said, I have to go to see how is it, so I must go. So I don't understand. And besides this, he spoke Divrei Torah. And there is a halacha, when somebody travel, always it's good to speak a halacha, Shemitoch kach zocher oto. It's good. So they spoke about Egla Arufa, they spoke a halachot, so that this the mitzvah of this halacha, there is a malach that is created by this halacha, and this malach, he protects the man who travel. So I don't understand. There is a man, there is a malach who was created for with the Dvar Torah that Yosef spoke to his father. There is another mitzvah, kibud av ha'em. And then what happened to him? Poor man. They nearly killed him. Look what happened to him. Others, who is the shlochim mitzvah inam nizukim? And I remember as well, there is another question about Sarah Imenu. When Avraham Abinu took Yitzhak to sacrifice him, then Sarah, somebody came and told him, you know what happened? What happened? You know that Abraham, he took Yitzhak to sacrifice him. No, so what happened at the end? So he did not sacrifice him at the end. At the end, there was a malach who told him stop. And according to Chachamim, she died because of that. Sarah Imenu died because why? Maybe Yitzhak is not Ra'ui. He don't deserve to be sacrificed to Hashem. So she was so in pain why Yitzhak was not sacrificed, so she died. I don't understand. Shluchim mitzvah einam nizukin. Abraham took Yitzhak on the order of Hashem to sacrifice him. It's a mitzvah. And of course, Abraham Abinu, through this mitzvah, he created a malach, a big malach. And this malach, his name is Sacrifice, Akedat Yitzhak. Up to now, when Hashem sees that malach, he remembers what Abraham did. So, why Sarah had to die? Why Sarah died? For this mitzvah. Shluchi mitzvah einam nizukim. And instead of being alive, בסדר, she loved HaKadosh Baruch Hu, but why she had to die? Because of this mitzvah that it has not been done. You know, my friend, this week Be'ez Hashem is Hanukkah. And we see באמת what it is, שליחי מצווה אינם נזוקים. And few days, we saw, you know, all of you the story, how the Hashmonaim defeat the Greek. The Greek, they came to Eretz Israel to assimilate the Jews. They did not destroy the Beit HaMikdash. For them, the Beit HaMikdash is not worth it. If there is no Torah, there is no Beit HaMikdash. For them, the most important thing was to stop the Avodat Hashem. If they will stop the Jews from serving Hashem, it's finished. Finished. According to some big rabbis, they said, why the Greek came to Eretz Israel? Because she nitrash lo ba'avoda, because they did not serve Hashem as they should do. To serve Hashem, you have to put Hashem always in priority. Do we put Hashem in priority? No. The morning is a cigarette, is the coffee, is some phone calls. Always, and then after it's Hashem. Do we put Eretz Yisrael? In a few months, there will be the Mondial. The Mondial, you will see people will wake up at 2 o'clock, at 3 o'clock, at 4 o'clock, at 5 o'clock, and for a mitzvah, they will not do it. So this is, always we should put Hashem in priority. Always, the Baal Shem Tov said, why there is no Yirat Shamayim? Why there is a lot of religious people? They have no Yirat Shamayim. They don't fear. They do mitzvot, they study Torah, but you feel there is no Yirat Shamayim. And the Baal Shem Tov said, the Yirat Shamayim come when you give all the time priority to Hashem. When you give priority to yourself, to your own thing, and after you remember there is Hashem, so you will have less Yirat Shamayim. The Yirat Shamayim come when Bemet you go, you give. I wake up in the morning for Hashem. I don't wake up for work, first for Hashem. Anyway, you have to work. But at least I wake up for Hashem. I wake up, there is Hashem first. After it's taking children to school, then after a coffee, then after this. But first it's Hashem. So now you see, the Greek, all what they wanted, the Greek, is to make the Jews less serving Hashem. That's why the first thing they did, that they started to create space for sport. Sport here, sport there, you know, sport, les Jeux Olympiques, all games, Olympic games. That's what there was there, because they knew that by teaching the, you know, all those games to the Jews, so the Jews, they will give it, they will get used to it, and then they will start to give less priority to Hashem. And then, when the Greeks saw that they won the game, so then they stopped completely the Avodat Hashem. They stopped the Kohanim from working the Beit HaMikdash, and then Hashmonaim, they had no choice. They went to fight. They were five against thousands of Greek. There you see, Shluchi mitzvah einam nizukim. There you see that Behemet, the Hashmonaim, the way, I can imagine five people fighting thousands of people. It's impossible. It's not logical. It's not possible. I don't know. It's not, but for them it was, we are the Shluchim, we represent the Am Israel. The Am Israel now is nearly finished. It's nearly all of them, they are assimilated. They don't believe in Hashem anymore. The Beit HaMikdash is closed. There is no Avodah. There is no Kohanim. There is no Torah. As the Greek did, that there is no Shabbat. Anyone who respects Shabbat, he was killed. Any woman that she go to the Mikvish was killed. No Brit Milah, no Nida, no Shabbat, no Rosh Chodesh, no Tefillin. Can you imagine if there is no all those mitzvot, it's finished. Finished. At least even a Jew, I was very happy last week, two weeks ago. There was, you know, it's very hot today in Brazil. It's very, very hot. 36 degrees, it was when I was there two weeks ago. And there is, unfortunately, the women, they are not snowed. So we prepared them some clothes when they come to see me to put some clothes. And there was a religious woman that she came, and I told her, I wish if all those women that they are here, they put, you know, they wear that snout like you. You know what was her answer? It was the first woman that she beat me. She knocked me out, you know, down. What she told me, she said, okay, they are not snout, but at least they came to say rabbi. At least they came to say rabbi. They believe. Otherwise, they don't know. I told you, right. Thank you. You teach me something. Always you have to be Adam Adam is kafzchot. Yeah, always you have to try to find good words for on a Jew. They don't know. I can imagine if she knew that she's not allowed to wear, not to be tzniot in front of me. They would do it, but they don't know. You see, why they don't know? Because there is no Torah, because they don't study Torah. That means, without studying Torah, you know nothing. But you can imagine, that's what happened at the time of the Greek. They forbidden to study Torah. So you can imagine, with no Torah, with nothing, so they become like Greek. And then the Hashmonaim, they went to fight them. And the Kadosh Baruch Hu did a big miracle. Why? Because Shluchei Mitzvah Enam Nizukin. So now we understand about Hashmonaim. Baruch Hashem, they won the war, they won the battle. Shluchei Mitzvah Enam Nizukin. A man who goes to do a mitzvah, he is sure that nothing bad will happen to him. So our question is about Yosef. And our question is about Rabbi Akiva. How Rabbi Akiva? He was studying Torah. All the Asara Harugim Malchut, all those big tzaddikim. What about the Shoah? What about a lot of big tzaddikim? They were killed. They were studying Torah. Yimach Shemam, the Nazi, they went to the Beit HaMidrash. They talked from the Beit HaMidrash, people that they were praying, people that they were studying, and they killed them with their tefillin on. They killed and showed them. Shtoi mitzvah inen nizukim. We say that when you do a mitzvah, you don't get hurt. So, why Rabbi Akiva? Look the way he was killed, Rabbi Akiva. Why he was hurt? Why? Rabotai, my friend, I would like just to tell you this. How much even one of us should just think about Yaakov Abinu? Yaakov Abinu, alav shalom. Hashem told him, go back home from Haran. Now, he was married with children, four wives, a rich man. And then he was worried about when he saw that Esav is going to come to fight him. The same question, Shluchei Mitzvah Enam Nizukim. You go home with the permission of Hashem. Hashem promised you to protect you. What are you afraid of? Shluchei Mitzvah Enam Nizukim. I want to teach you one thing, all of you, my friend. You should know that Beseder, Sarai Minu, she should not be hurt. Rabbi Akiva, he should not be hurt by the Roman because he was studying Torah. Yosef, he should not be hurt because he went in the order of his father. But one thing you have to know, that there is tzaddikim that they love so much HaKadosh Baruch Hu. They love him so much. They're so connected to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. They love so much HaKadosh Baruch Hu. When a mitzvah comes to their hand, they want really to give their soul for that mitzvah. They don't want the idea that they will not be hurt. didn't want the idea. Didn't want the idea that he would not be hurt by doing this mitzvah. Rabbi Akiva, he loved so much HaKadosh Baruch Hu that really he wanted to die for the mitzvah because he was learning to the Torah when he was cut. You know, there's Hachamim who said when Rabbi Akiva, the groomman, were killing him, he went like this: Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Ehad. He was saying the Shema Israel with so much consultation, with so connected to Hashem. Hachamim, they told him, Rabbeinu, Atkan, this is the way you love Hashem. You love Hashem. You've been hurt by the Roman. They're killing you slowly, instead of screaming with pain. You mention Shema Israel. You know what he answered them? He said, all my life I was asking myself, do I love Hashem? Do I really love Hashem? Maybe we think we love Hashem. Who knows? Who can prove you that you love Hashem? Yes, we are here. We come the morning, we pray, we wake up. I do a lot of mitzvot, but what proof I have that I love Hashem? What proof I have that I will give my soul for Kiddush Hashem? What proof I have? Tell me, I have no proof. I don't know. That's what Rabbi Akiva was his answer. He said, all my life I was asking Hashem, myself, do really I love Hashem with my heart, with my soul, with my money? Do really I love Him? Yes, I love Him, but I have no proof. So now that I can prove to myself, I can prove to Hashem that I love Him with my soul, with my heart, I will miss this mitzvah. Hashem. That means from that answer, we understand that Rabbi Akiva, he didn't want that he will be saved from being killed because he was studying Torah. Yes, shtohe mitzvah elam nizukim. Yes, a man who do a mitzvah, he's not getting hurt. Why Rabbi Akiva? Because Rabbi Akiva really, he wanted to get hurt. He wanted really to prove to himself that because he wanted to prove to himself that he loves Hashem, so Hashem said, okay, you want to die for me? So you can die. Or, you know, the Alexander Rebbe, when they took him to the chamber of gas, with some of his Hasidim, when they took his clothes off, and he was singing, Baruch Hu Elokeinu Shepra'anu Lechvodo V'Ibdilanu Me'atoim, he was singing. He said to his Talmidim, let's sing, we're going to go now to be killed for Hashem. Let's show to Hashem that we love Him. And that moment we have to show Him that we love Him. That means he did not pray to be saved. No, he was a big tzaddik. Those people who wanted to kill him, he could kill them with his mouth if he want. But no, he didn't want. All those tzaddikim that they were killed for Kiddush Hashem, they was a big tzaddikim. They could save themselves if they want. No. They wanted really, this loved so much Hashem, they didn't want that all the schuyot, all the merit will stop them, not will protect them not to get killed. Now you understand Sarah Imenu, she loved so much Hashem that she wanted that Yitzhak, he would be sacrificed. When she heard that Yitzhak is not sacrificed, she had pain. She said, ay, maybe you don't deserve. So what I've done, maybe it's my fault. She had so much pain because she loved so much HaKadosh Baruch Hu. She wanted be'emet really that her son will be sacrificed for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. B'derech she'adam holech molechinoto. And the way that a man wants to go to the Shamaim, they help him to realize his desire. Tzadikim, they don't want to be, when they do a mitzvah, they want to do it b'mesirut nefesh, they do it with sacrifice. They don't want to be saved by doing this mitzvah. They want really to go till the end for Hashem. Now you understand Yosef, the same. Yosef at Tzadik Alav HaShalom is completely different. Be'emet shlohi mitzvah enam nizukin for Yosef. Baruch Hashem, this mitzvah of kibud av va'em that he did by going to see how his brothers, even that they don't like him, even that they hate him, maybe they will kill him, but still that mitzvah, he saved him. I think is that mitzvah who saved him during 22 years in Egypt, that he was not assimilated. There is a lot of ways how mitzvah that you do can protect you. Maybe the mitzvah that you do can protect you right away, maybe not right away, maybe 20 years, maybe for your children, and maybe there is tzaddikim that really they want to go till the end. They don't want to leave. They want to give their soul for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. They have to love Hashem with all your heart, with your brain, with your soul, with your money, everything. And that's no one knows how much we love HaKadosh Baruch Hu. At least we don't need to die for Hashem to prove to ourselves that we love Hashem. If we do a mitzvah, if you want to speak Lashon Hara, and suddenly you don't speak Lashon Hara, it's a miserot nefesh, it's a sacrifice. There is a woman who passed, and they have a tzara to look at her, and you don't look at her, it's a miserot nefesh, it's a sacrifice. There is a lot of ways of sacrifice. Sacrifice, it's not only to give your soul for Hashem to die, no. You can do a sacrifice and still alive. That way, I'm sorry to be long, that way in the Kriyat Shema we say, Ve'avta et Hashem Elokecha, you should love Hashem, your God, Bechol Levavcha, with all your heart, Bechol Levavcha, with your soul, and with your money. Why with your money? Because even the money, there is a sacrifice. When you do tzedakah, it's from your money you give, it's a sacrifice. So it's a sacrifice. You did a sacrifice. You did tzedakah. You see, sacrifice is not only giving your soul. Sacrifice is as well when you do something from your body. You wake up in the morning to serve Hashem. You do chesed with a friend. It's a miserut nefesh. So Rabotai, I would just tell you this. Shlohei mitzvah inam nizokim. You do a mitzvah, you can be sure that you will not be hurt. You know why? Because when you do a mitzvah, it's a sacrifice you do when you do this mitzvah. So this mitzvah protects you. But as I told you before, there is a lot of levels on mitzvot. There is tzaddikim, they are very high level, that they want to do the mitzvot till the end. Till the end. Like the time Nadav Abihu. Nadav Abihu, they want to do a mitzvah. And why they have to be killed? Why they die? Because really, Nadav Abihu, they wanted to, because they wanted to sacrifice themselves for HaKadosh Baruch Hu. There is a lot of ways, of levels of sacrifice. There is levels of Misirut Nefesh, like Nadav Abihu. There is levels like Rabbi Akiva. There is levels of sacrifice, like Yaakov Avinu, Yosef HaTzadik, Abraham Avinu, Sarah Imenu. And there is another level that I want to do the mitzvah, but I want this mitzvah to protect me. I don't want to die. So Hashem said, okay, you will live. Mitzvah inam nizokim. My friend, now you understand. The Hashmonaim, they say to Hashem, Mi kamocha ba'elim Hashem. We don't want to die by putting ourselves on Sirut Nefesh to give our soul, because Am Yisrael didn't need us. We have to teach them Torah. So we want to go to fight, but we want to stay alive. So Shlochei Mitzvah Enam Nizukim. So Baruch Hashem, up to now, we mentioned the Hashmonaim. Because Hashmonaim, they realize that if they die in the battle against the Greek, who will teach Torah to the Ben Israel? Who will light the candles on the Beit HaMikdash? The Am Yisrael need them. When Rabbi Yosef Alav HaShalom, I was in Israel when he passed away. When you see those millions of people, we never saw a Levaya like this Levaya. Behemet, I'm telling you, it's something inimaginable. Even I never saw a president, I never saw somebody what they did for him. My friend, one thing I want to tell you, that when this tzaddik, how much miserut nefesh, when he was very, very ill, all Am Yisrael prayed for him. But he was 93 years old. He was very ill. I mean, the last day, that famous Monday, that he passed away, I remember everywhere in Eretz Yisrael they prayed for him. Because the world needed him. Yes, he's old man. Yes, he is very ill. But if he can stay alive another week, another 2 weeks, he can bring a lot of to the Jews. This is the Hashmonaim. The Hashmonaim, when they want to fight against the Greek, they went, Mi kamocha, who is like you, Hashem? Mi kamocha, who is like you, Hashem? And they went with tefillot, they went to come back. Because Am Yisrael need them. When we pray to Frat Tzadik that he's not well, even that he's very old man, but we need him. Am Yisrael need him. Who can take over his place? No one. So Rabotai, there is a lot of levels. I'm sure for Rabbi Ode Yosef, he accomplished his Avodat Hashem. I mean, he was like a malach, so he could die, but maybe for him, he think that he reached the shlimut, he reached the what Hashem wants for him. But for us, we want him still alive. Why? Because there is something to learn from him. My friend, this is the message. The message is Shluchim mitzvah inam nizokim. There is a lot of levels. Oh, when somebody does a mitzvah, he is not hurt. There is a lot of people. They give a lot of tzedakot, and they become poor today. Why we don't see? Why we see that the tzedakah protects you? The tzedakah, anyone who gives tzedakah, he becomes rich. Why they are poor? Well, these questions, we have no answer for that. But maybe he's rich. He's alive. He's alive. You know, to be alive, it's rich. He's rich. Maybe he has a gzera. Maybe he's supposed to die. And now he's alive. And Be'ez Hashem will do mitzvot, more mitzvot. And there is a lot of level. And there is a lot of people that they lost their money. They did a lot of mitzvot. You know what they told me? We are happy today, Baruch Hashem, that I have no money. I can study Torah. Be'emet. Ah, Baruch Hashem. Before, I had no time to study Torah. Now, oof, I'm happy. So you see, Shvachim Mitzvahin and Mizukim. I mean, he did a lot of mitzvot. He created a lot of yeshivot. Now he has nothing. He's happy. Now he can study Torah. Let somebody else be English. Of course, all of us, we want to remain rich. We want to remain, as I told you, this is a result of labors. Yer Ratzon, Shekosh Baruch Hu, we give you bracha, betzlacha, yuta guf. Don't forget one message. When you light the candles of Hanukkah, you have to pray that you will have to banim tamidei hachamim. This is because the Nes, the battle of the Greek against the Jews, is not finished yet. The assimilation, it's not finished yet. The battle is not finished yet. Look today at the technology. Today, what's going on today? Shemishbor. So when you light the candles, connect yourself with the Hashmonaim, what happened to them with the Greece, with the Greek. What really the Greek wanted? They wanted to assimilate the Jews. Today no one forced us to be assimilated. But today, with all what's going on in the world, we assimilate ourselves without being forced to be assimilated. So the war against the Greek, those Greek of before, is not finished yet. When you light the candle of Hanukkah, bayamim haem, bazeman hazeh, it's not finished yet, the miracle. So you have to focus praying for your children, to have children that believe in HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And Be'ezat Hashem, through the candle, the or the light of the candle of Hanukkah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we give you clarity, light in your home, in your house, and in your house. <answer. laughs>